Russia's PAK-DA stealth bomber top speed. The stealth bomber PAK-DA, which is currently in its development stage, will replace Moscow's aging fleet of bombers. It has now been reported that Russia is already bench testing several prototypes of the Izdeliye product, RF engine that it is developing to power the PAK-DA strategic bombers. It is noteworthy that the Russian stealth bomber, which will be used to carry heavy payload and state-of-the-art weaponry, is being developed as a subsonic bomber, less than the speed of sound, in the hypersonic era. Countries like the US and China are working on hypersonic flights already. However, Russia deliberately chose to keep its next-generation bomber with stealth features as a subsonic platform. Air Marshal Anil Chopra, retired, who is also the Director General of the Center for Air Power Studies, said, "The United States B-2 Spirit stealth bomber is subsonic and most likely, so is the upcoming B-21 Raider, which will be unveiled in December. These bombers are designed to operate at subsonic speeds as they need a very long range and must carry a very heavy payload. The Russian PAK-DA will also have hypersonic missiles, so it does need to fly at very high speed. Only the US, China, and Russia have successfully developed and deployed stealth aircraft. The fact that the Russian PAK-DA will be a stealth bomber meant for long-range operations also has much to do with Tupolev going with a subsonic platform. Bombers have no requirement for hypersonic or even supersonic flight because they can carry hypersonic missiles. They do not need to penetrate adversary airspace. Bombers need to be able to stay in the air for long durations, so that they can launch hypersonic missiles as soon as a threat emerges. Subsonic flight increases the endurance of an aircraft. Therefore, subsonic bombers that cannot be detected by adversary radar because of stealth are preferred now. That subsonic flight is more stealthy than supersonic or hypersonic flight because there is no skin heating. The hypersonic flight will cause heating of the fuselage surface, and the threat will be more easily detectable by thermal imaging satellites or ground sensors. The flying wing PAK-DA can fly at subsonic speeds for 30 hours and has an engine with a thrust of roughly 23 tons. According to a Popular Mechanics article from August, Russia has fewer tanker planes for mid-air refueling, hence the PAK-DA would have a greater range than the B-2 Spirit. The next generation aircraft will contain new technology and materials to lower its radar signature. In the PAK-DA bomber, a flying wing design does not have a tail surface for stability and maneuverability, and the fuselage and wings are fused. The layout reduces radar signature. The flight computer uses electrically actuated wing-mounted aerodynamic surfaces, like flaps, to achieve stability and maneuverability. The low observable, low, flying wing bomber can operate in tandem with drones and carry a hypersonic missile in its internal bomb bay. Russia currently has three distinct hypersonic missiles: Avangard, Zircon, and Kintsal. In contrast with Russia's lagging low observable bomber program, the US B-21 Raider stealth bomber will finally be revealed to the public later this year, as announced by the manufacturer Northrop Grumman in a pompous public ceremony. Besides the US and Russia, China is also working on a next-gen stealth bomber codenamed the H-20. All three next-gen bombers are most certainly going to be flying wing designs. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.